Hey everyone, welcome into another episode of American Truck Simulator. Hope you guys are doing well today. We're, of course, set for some more trucking. I don't know why I went to the used trucks. I should look at my trucks, because I do have that one. Was it the Kenworth? Yeah. Needs some help, if you will, but it does need a driver, so let's hire someone. Rating's not bad. The nice thing is they've got three. Ooh. Let's hire Marianne and... Cool. Now we have three drivers. And again, I know that Kenworth isn't in the best of shape, but, you know, it's all right. How many miles does the thing have? Well, I guess since we've had it, doesn't say. Doesn't matter. All right, let's try and get us a job here. We were near Albuquerque, of course. Garbage truck. It's got to go to Oxnard. $60,000. $18,000. You know what? Yeah, let's do a long one. This will be a longer, probably two-part episode going to Reno, Nevada. $84,000. They need it by Saturday at noon. It's currently Thursday afternoon. Sure. Let's do it. Let's do a big one. I should actually fix my truck up too, because it does need some work. Many of you remember from last episode, had a few mishaps, if you will. And at least with the truck, it is made for definitely made for made for pulling. Apologize, I was kind of hearing some noises outside my recording area here, so I was trying to listen to see if it was something I needed to be concerned of or not, and it was definitely not something I needed to worry about, so. Alright. But yeah, as I was saying, probably should get this fixed. Okay, so we need to stay in this lane. Drive the 20 miles to the Peterbilt dealership. Guessing this is, yeah. And it's a new area we haven't been to yet, so. There, set the cruise at 70. We're at least full fuel, so I guess. Well, actually, at the dealership, we will be able to get it fixed, so. We will be okay, actually. And I believe it's a Peterbilt dealer. Gotta give shout out to the other Peterbilt dealers. See Buildmaster, he's got the doubles on. Yeah, I'm pretty sure we're on red light, so that was also why I wasn't going super, super fast. Because A, it was going to take some time, with having the doubles in front of us, and it was red, so what's the point of rushing? Will it have me go both ways? It might, but it also might not. I don't know if I've ever gotten stuck with, like, the train tracks, if you will. Maybe once, like many, many episodes ago. Then maybe. That might have been, but otherwise, no. Did you have the truck dealer? What I'm actually going to look for first. There we go. We're gonna go fix the fix our truck up for actually. Yeah, we could do this. Alright, so 85,000 basically. So we're going to take the job. First thing we are doing though, we are going to get our semi repaired. Get it all fixed up. Serviced. We're going to repair all. And done. And done. Oh, let's just spin around in here. Close. All right. Oh yeah, this will always be the well, we're not super close, so. All right. Back yourselves up. Set. So of course we're going to the Peterbilt dealer, Peterbilt dealership in Reno. 54,800 pounds. Just trying to make sure they can all get there. So yeah, again, Saturday 1:34 to 5:44, 84,892. So be a nice. Ugh. Wait, did I actually hit a vehicle? Did I? Like, okay. Well, that's because I hit the semi? Not fully sure. Oh, shoot. We should have went the other way. Okay, so we are going after this vehicle. Still good. Yep. This actually is, like, pulling fairly easy. I don't know why I thought maybe it would pull a little bit harder than what it is. But, I mean, regardless, it's working. see here. Green. Yep, it'll take us a little bit. Yeah, going to Reno. 18 hours basically. 1,000 miles. 10:05 is what we're projected. That would be if we were able to make it like straight. Straight up all the ways. Nice looking Peterbilt, though. Two and then one. Oh no, I gotta wait because the other one needs the. Need the green arrow. Oh. What is this in every, like, one side then the other side style? Okay, maybe? Alright. Now we can get, well, we'll have to wait. Side will have it first, so there we go. Green. Well, I guess we have a little bit of room. We can move up a little bit. It's a sharp looking semi. I feel like I do want to kind of change the color though. Oh, I bet it's a. Oh. Okay. I was thinking it was a, like, we would have to yield. Surprisingly enough, we don't. Because I definitely figured we would have. Oh, and this will be all new. Maybe we haven't gone this way before. Get in the middle here, and if this could be a straight where it's strictly just where we're basically on the same interstate. Now I know we will kind of dip with speed limits more than likely, but that part of it would be nice to just stay on one side, if you will. Just wanted to make sure because I didn't want, because they would come into me and then I would get the ticket. I know that's what would happen. So Interstate 40 is what we're on. Again, from Albuquerque, New Mexico to Reno, Nevada. So we will at least drive around one more city in New Mexico. And then of course all of Arizona, but we've been through Arizona plenty of times. It might now finish some of the roads. Like, that would be interesting to see what we have left. I was going to say, oh yeah, we could even, you know, do like our stop at our main area, but that doesn't matter anyways because at our home base, because yeah, I don't know the last time we've been to the home base. Could almost start buying more garages. Get more and more income streaming in. But it'd be nice to take the three that we have and then get their stars up higher, so then you're really making a lot of money. And I'm sure it takes a lot of time to get them super far up, just like it does us. I mean, level 26 and We still have, I mean, all of the fuel economy ones, which I've left those for last because at the end of the day, I really don't care about the fuel economy. I haven't, being we don't have all of the states that are available bought, I don't know. I haven't gotten to a point where I'm like, oh, I wish I got 50% better fuel mileage. Like, eh. You know, you can kind of plan them with when you're stopping to sleep, so I am kind of okay with it in that regard. So, which is fine. So we will just, you know, keep going. I think Fragile is the last one we are working on, and I think we've got 3 or 4 left on that, and then we're set to go. I will say, with this new update from American Truck Simulator, I definitely feel like one of them is there's way more traffic. Like, I feel like traffic has gotten intense, where there's just more of it, like busier areas, if you will. Because, I mean, this is a lot of traffic. Granted, it's a Thursday, it's rush hour. Maybe that's part of it. And, you know, which would make sense, we're in the westbound lane, so most people would be leaving out of Albuquerque, even though we're kind of a ways out now. And then, of course, you'd have the other side. And at least, too, with this, you know, 1,000 miles, I mean, we'll be able to drive. I mean, not super far, but we still have about 100 miles left. Yeah, see, kind of getting stuck with some of this slower traffic. Because we're getting good speed, and then it's just getting boxed. Like some sardines. Right? Yeah. Alright, come on. Not close to our destination, but I was thinking like, oh, close to speed limit, but nope, we're still slowly getting back up there. Just a longer drive. Oop. Let's get below that 70 threshold. At least stay in this lane. Because we will get 75, or, well, the miles per hour right here will go. Speed limit will go up 75, yep. So now it's kind of like, alright, we've got a gotta get back to it. See, there we go. Come on. You're doing real well there, semi. The old Peterbilt. See, and again, you do more of these. I mean, it won't take long and we'll be 100,000 miles. Cruise is set to 80. Because again, then we don't have to worry about getting a speeding ticket, because, you know, 5 you're fine, 7 you're mine. Rule. Okay. So I've got to tell you, I think there's someone... I don't... Gotta get over here. Which one's the way station? Oh, right here. See, now that's something that needs to be kind of fixed. Is it takes so long for it to show? I guess I could have looked at the other map. 77,160. Not bad. 23,000 pound semi, give or take. Anyways, as I was saying, as I feel like there's people cutting trees down or something, outside my room where I'm recording in, because I feel like I can hear a chainsaw going, but then I'm like, I'm in town next to no trees whatsoever, so I don't really know how that's possible, unless someone is just straight up vacuuming, I guess, which is a possibility. I definitely bet we're, yep. So now we did that little roundabout. So now we are into Arizona, and or we will be shortly when we get to Holbrook for sure. But we have gone this route, as you can see, as it's been covered. So, which is totally fine. Nothing wrong with that. We are just going to keep on trucking. Again, we've got 15 hours to go, 852 miles. So 10:15 a.m. on Friday is what the projected time would be. Of course, that will not happen, as we will need to sleep. I'm hoping, from the looks of it, we might be for sure halfway to needing to rest. I'm hoping that we can get down to 8 hours, where let's say it's just a full day tomorrow, Friday, of driving, because they don't need it till Saturday at 1:30 at the earliest. They will definitely be getting it on Friday. It's more so a matter of when, depending on how long we're able to drive. Like, it was what, almost 2 a.m. I think when our driver went to bed. So I mean, we've got theoretically, what, 6-7 more hours of driving if we wanted. So, you know, I mean, we could be getting pretty far at that point. And especially if we don't really deal with any more or too much more for stops and stuff, and we can just drive. I'm gonna turn on the lights. Kind of surprised I hadn't gotten a light ticket, being it was 8:45 already. Gotta get back into the groove of that, because those tickets are just very unfortunate. Let's see here. So yeah. So we'll say 5.5 hours, give or take, left of driving. Because when it was like 2 o'clock or 1:30 when we went to bed, I think I got hit with at least one fine, almost two. So it was past that point. Yeah, I'm telling you, someone's cutting something. Or they've got a really nasty vacuum that's definitely not sounding right. Still 10 o'clock. I mean, again, we are just cruising, pulling the Peterbilts. If you're just joining us now, pulling Peterbilts. We started in Albuquerque, New Mexico, and now, of course, we are going to Reno, Nevada, to the Peterbilt dealer there in town. So, right now we're in Arizona. We got through Holbrook 10 minutes ago, game time, give or take. So right now we're just, you know, driving along. Again, I love this. We're on one main drag. We don't have to worry about highway speeds, if you will. I mean, this is how you can really make up time, if you will, by being able to drive 75, 80 miles an hour instead of having to worry and going, well, shoot, I can only go 55, so 60 at the most if I don't want to deal speeding tickets. And of course, there are the people that play this game where they're just like, well, maybe they take off traffic or you can't have damage or tickets. And I do my best to be as realistic as possible. Of course, I have done my fair share, like blowing through stop signs or, you know, I'm sure I've done a few things where I was kind of cheating the system a little bit. I definitely went like 20 over. Again, I was kind of risking it because I was like, well, okay, I'm just going to chance it. Could have easily gotten a ticket, but just trying to be a realistic, safe semi-driver, if you will. Which I do wonder, so when I did that fender bender, which probably would have killed those people in those cars, in that car in real life last episode, I do wonder if I had a big push bar on the front, bull bar, if you will, if that would have actually done less damage or anything like that. I do wish too that at least on your own rig, A, you can see dirt, things of that nature, do car washes. Again, minor things like that. But also that, like, damage was more realistic. Give me, like, GTA. Of course, Beam and P is a whole different animal with that. So, not as realistic to do. But I just think some of this would be, you know, a fun thing to do. Okay, I should get over. Oop. Okay, I'll wait till this car gets past us, and then I will turn over. Watch, by this point, I will get back up to speed, kind of like I'm doing right now. And then I'll be passing the car again. There we go. Get the downward slope. Get that speed up a lot faster. We got 9:15. Again, we got 12 and a half hours to go. 700 miles left. Right now, 9:51 a.m. on Friday is the projection. So that was the case, and we drove till 1. I mean, yeah, we're probably still at, 8 hours? You know, that we will have left. Oh, what did she do? Income. 125K, why? What the heck did she just do? Oh, I'm wondering, with that semi being a 2-star, maybe she had to fix something or get something fixed? I'm guessing, because 125K, I don't know why else I would have gotten dinged like that. Probably should have went and actually drove it and looked at it. Alright. Oh, there we go. The car is going to move out of the way for us. So that we can keep moving. Just about 10 p.m. now. under 12 hours, 655 for miles left. Again, we've got some Peterbilts that we're delivering from. They're coming from the Peterbilt dealership in Albuquerque, going to the Peterbilt dealership in Reno, Nevada. So, again, I do hope you guys are liking this series. If you're not, I mean, that's fine too. Again, as I've stated many, many times, this is really just kind of a fun leisure thing for me. Just kind of driving the roads, if you will. And I can see how maybe these are a little tougher because, I mean, you're just watching someone drive, if you will. Now, you could go, well, maybe you should, you know, stream to Twitch or, you know, YouTube, whatever the case is. And a person could do that, but for one, my machine that I play on isn't robust enough to really handle live streaming while recording. It's just not built that way, which is okay. It's kind of how I chose it. I really didn't want to pay an arm and a leg at first. I just wanted to slowly get into this, and so that's what I'm doing. So that's okay. I am waiting for him, so it looks like, yeah, I feel like he'd be yawning the next hour or two. Whoop. Got off the road. I wonder, too, if I could look and see what was the reasoning for the $125,000. Like, what did I just owe on what? Especially because it didn't tell me why. There's no short messages, anything of that nature, so. Kingman. And we are just going to gamble it, if you will. We are going to have to turn up ahead here. As we will be kind of getting off the main drag, because we are not going into California, of course. We are going into Reno, so into Nevada. So, we will have to turn off. 10.5 hours to go, 10:23. So, yeah, it's going to be close then. Maybe it will be Saturday morning by the time we get there. Interstate 90, or Highway 93 we're on right now. And getting back to like the streaming stuff, so for me, for instance, I'm very upfront with everyone. I do minimal editing, kind of take the front and the back off, because again, I'm just really just doing this for leisure. And I get it. If I did streaming, it would make more sense, because then people would probably, anyone that wanted to watch, could easily do that. So at some point, I'm sure we will get there, just not right now. And it depends too with my work schedule. Right now it's a little slower because of the holiday season, but it'll definitely pick up once Christmas is over and the new year is here. So then my time isn't is open, so it gets to be a tougher situation with trying to have enough episodes planned out for everyone. Because that's been the biggest challenge, right? As I'm a non-streamer, but as someone that does watch a handful of streamers that I like, that I subscribe to, you know, you almost have to stay consistent, because in this day and age especially, everyone just wants, you know, something now. They want it now, and to stay relevant, sometimes as a content creator, you have to kind of push yourself, which then can take away from giving yourself the necessary breaks that are needed and to make sure you don't get burnt out. You know, so it's just one of those things that you always just want to be careful of.